This was during a plenary sitting in which the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, presented a statement on the emerging issues at NSSF stemming from a letter authored by Amongi questioning the reappointment of the NSSF former Managing Director, Richard Byarugaba, when his contract expired at the end of November 2022.
At Rule 190, I am referring this to a select committee, and we shall have very able people who can never be compromised to handle this matter. I will announce the names of the five people on Monday.
In her statement to Parliament, Amongi noted that members' funds are safe and invested in fixed assets, equities, and real estate.
Right Honourable Speaker and members, members' funds are safe. And I want to repeat that members' funds are safe and protected. While, and you have seen the statistics of the payment we have done in the last 2 months.
She added that although the president and the NSSF board had recommended the reappointment of Byarugaba and his deputy Patrick Ayota, a number of petitions had been presented to several authorities, including the president, prime minister, the coordinator of Operation Wealth Creation, the Inspector General of Government, and herself against Byarugaba.
In all the strategic meetings we were having, it was how do we handle the petition? And so that is when the meeting of 22nd with HE decided that since, and I want to state here that Richard Byarugaba was in State House on 22nd when that decision was made.
However, the speaker questioned Amongi on why she had to go against the board's recommendation to have Byarugaba reappointed, and the minister said that it was within her mandate to ensure that the petitions against the former managing director are first cleared.
We want the house to know what is happening. We want the house to know what is in the law, why you did not do it. Is it because of the investigation? If those petitions are cleared, you have cleared us. So when the board recommends to the minister and a petition comes, which is fundamental, I consulted. And that consultation led to a decision that please first hold on. And by the way, we were given 60 days to undertake that investigation.
MPs alleged that the failure by Byarugaba to clear 6 billion shillings needed for the strategic direction of growing the fund is the reason why the minister declined to reappoint him. But Amongi refuted the report.
You look at the project, the residential apartments that are being constructed in Lwowa, they are also under stall, and people are giving the same reasons.
There is no way, of course, we can trust a team of 5 or maybe 8 people on the outcomes on the investigations that are being carried out. And we also need powers, we as members of parliament, as in to access the accounts or maybe the banks where this NSSF institution, of course, keeps the Ugandans' money, such that we can justify, such that we can speak out of evidence other than we basing on the reports of the ministers, of which we have no basis to justify the truthfulness of the report.
Finance Minister Matia Kasaija declined to make any submission on the activities of NSSF and asked Parliament to make his statement at a later date.
Thank you very much.
Honourable members, listen to the minister.
Honourable Speaker, unfortunately, I was not informed to come prepared to this house. No, I don't want to come and talk to you when I'm not prepared. I was taught that way, that when you are talking to important people, you prepare yourself.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.